So, you already understand that proper hot holding means keeping time and temperature control for safety foods, also known as TCS foods, at 135 degrees or higher. But if you're still having issues with hot holding, you may want to ask yourself some questions like, do all of my employees know which food items are TCS foods? How often are we taking temperatures? Are my employees logging the temperatures correctly, or even logging them at all? If you can't confidently answer those questions, then it's probably time to revise or create a new hot holding policy for your establishment. But first, what is a policy, and how do you create a hot holding policy for your business? A policy is a defined set of actions that minimize food safety risks. It's best to write your policies down to protect your customers and your business. Here are the fundamental steps to consider when developing any policy. Include key players in your workplace when it comes to hot holding. Identify the most important steps in your processes. Ensure that your policy includes corrective actions. Revise the policy on problems that arise or as your food processes change. Let's look at each of these steps more closely. Let's get the right people at the table to revise or create your new policy. That means getting your establishment's key players involved so that together you can identify the most important steps in your hot holding processes. That could be as simple as answering, who is responsible? What needs to happen? When does it take place? And where does it occur? Why does this policy exist? And how can your hot holding policy be practiced? The last step is to identify your corrective action, which is basically what to do if something isn't right. That means identifying what actions must be taken if hot holding temperatures are not holding above 135 degrees when you were doing your routine checks. And finally, just remember when implementing a newly written policy, they may not always work the first time, and that's okay. Gather your key players, come back to the table to discuss any policy shortcomings or oversights, and then go back and try it again. Once you've developed a policy that works, you are now ready to use that policy to train your staff. This will go a long way in bringing consistency on how hot holding is accomplished in your establishment. Remember, you and your staff will have to revisit and revise your policy when necessary and as your food processes change. To summarize, include the key people at the table. Identify the most important steps in your processes. Check that your policy answers questions who, what, when, where, why, and how. Ensure that your policy includes corrective actions. Revise the policy based on problems that arise or as your food processes change. Remember, having a written policy is the first step to protecting your customers, staff, and business from foodborne illnesses. But if you don't train your employees on your employee health policy, it won't do much. Be sure to demonstrate and explain your employee health policy to your staff, which we will explain in our next video.